for time.
Yep, okay, so once again, it is being recorded. Welcome to fifth grade. I'm Mr. Maturi. I'm one of the fifth grade teachers here. We also have Mrs. Payne over here. And then Ms. McGann. And we also have Elsie joining us tonight. Elsie.
It's me.
Our EA is Mr. Woodruff. Some of you might have seen him in the background of the camera. He's just helping out. He's a support in the classroom. He's been helping us out all year. And then we have Mrs. Pucci, who is a special ed director. So she's working with the kids that are on the IEPs. Continuing on. If you have a question, though, you can always put it in the chat box, just so you know. So here is for related arts. Mm-hmm. Pam, would you like to? It's good. Now, would you like to do the slide?
Oh, do you have the video that we have?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to talk about it first or just play the video?
Oh, you can just play the video. It explains itself.
Okay.
If they have questions, they can let me know.
Welcome, West Street Wildcat families. I'm Mrs. Pratt, and I teach technology and library skills. Hello, everyone. I'm Mrs. Goodnow. I teach music. Hi, I'm Ms. J or Ms. Jarvis, and I teach PE and health. Hi, I'm Ms. Moon. I'm the art teacher. Families, as you probably noticed, the specials look a little bit different. Instead of seeing all students every week, we've chunked the schedule for the protection of your students as well as the staff. So we're seeing one group of children each month. So each month we will move to a new set of students. When you enter into the Google Meet, if you are a remote student, you come to Google Classroom, and there's a Google Meet page. You click on that link and it will bring you to our meeting. In technology this year, it looks a little bit different because we're almost ready to get all of our students a Chromebook. But until then, we've had to be a little creative. So we've done a lot with digital citizenship and learning how to be safe on the internet, and we've taken some fun virtual field trips. So we've explored the San Diego Zoo, the Georgia Aquarium, and many other things. I'm gonna pass you on to the music teacher, Mrs. Goodnow, to explain what she's been doing in class.
Hello again. You would join my class in the same way. I just wanna say one quick thing. If you start or try to join in a little too early, you're not going to see the link right away. You might say, there is no link there. That's because I put it up as soon as I enter the classroom. So if it's not there yet, it will appear. And you would still click the same thing to join my meet. Now, what we're doing in music class this year is we have this special program called the Quaver Music. And it's a very fun program. The kids are enjoying it so much. There are so many activities. There are games and activities. Eventually, everyone is going to be getting their own student account, and so they'll be able to go in to Quaver themselves and do different activities and play different games. If you've already had music, you can talk about the Quaver 5. What is the Quaver 5? Children who have had music already will know what it is.
Hi, so for PE and health, at the beginning of the year, we have nice weather, so we're encouraging students to get outside and outside. So for the in-class students, I'm bringing them outside, so it's difficult for me to be live with the students that are doing virtual school. So for virtual PE right now, you're going to be responsible for doing your physical activity at home, and you're going to use this sort of map where it says Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. You just kind of go down the columns to do your physical activity. You have a warm-up, an open home activity, and if you keep scrolling on this, there's an activity log that you need to fill out every day, and then you submit it on Friday so that I know what physical activity you guys did at home. Eventually, I'll be live with you when we use the gym in the colder weather. That's all.
So you join art class the same way you join technology and music. You join my Google Meet, and you Make Art With Me is a class. I have some examples of art that students have made this year. Students have been doing a great job making art. If you want to scroll down to the first picture. These are collages. This is an example of a collage that students made inspired by Henri Matisse. Students also designed castles and showed the texture on castles in third grade. In fourth grade, students made 1-point perspective skyscrapers. We talked about how to show that things are getting farther away, or show that things look like they're farther away in a picture. And students in fifth grade and fourth grade also studied the human skeleton and showed bones and thought of different ways to show them with shapes. So students have been doing a great job making art in class, and I am excited to see what they make next. I hope that.
Are there any questions? Any question about the video you just saw about the specials?
Yeah, it's kind of a nice little hybrid, you know?
Yes, and yes, this is the place to be.
Sorry about that, but the video kept going. Okay, no questions are in the chat.
Any translation needed right now?
Maybe one, yeah, I think so. I'm going to do it first, and then you can do it. Okay, so some of the apps we use that actually we use as a translator would be Class Dojo, Google Translate. We have Mr. Ortiz as a family liaison. The family newsletters we send out that are from the curriculums, so like Math and Wonders, those also can be sent home in a Spanish version. And then we have peer assistance for in the classroom. So for Class Dojo, for example, with just a click of a button underneath a story post or a message, it will translate it right to Spanish for you. And the same thing for Google Translate, that's just right on our cell phone. So if we're in class and we need to do it real quick, we might use that.
Hola, hola. Mi nombre es Elsie. Estoy aquí solamente para traducirle. Nosotros usamos el método de la traducción, Class Dojo. Ustedes en ese método solamente entrarían, ustedes pueden copiar el mensaje y el mismo programa se lo traduce al español. De la misma manera, podemos, aquí en el salón usamos Google Translate en cualquier forma que sea necesario, donde necesitemos decirle algo al estudiante que no nos podamos entender, lo podemos usar en el teléfono o en algo similar. También tenemos a Ms. Ortiz como Family Liaison, que ella es la que nos ayuda a traducir todos nuestros documentos, etcétera, y es la persona a la que se le está haciendo un poco difícil comunicarse con nosotros en el español, en inglés, podrías comunicarte con ella para cualquier pregunta en español. So, las noticias familiares del programa están en inglés y en español, así es que tenemos la opción para que ustedes puedan estar ahí. Y obviamente, ¿verdad?, también en la escuela nosotros tenemos la ayuda de nuestros mismos estudiantes que sirven como traductores muchas veces.
Okay, I'm sure we've all seen this before. This is posted in Google Classroom. It's on our Class Dojos. This is our remote schedule and in-person schedule. Yes, it is color-coded, so the in-person students go through this whole schedule, but the remote students only will be here for the blue. So we start off in the morning at 8:15 to 8:45, we eat breakfast. At this time, some students are starting to log in for morning meeting. That's from 8:45 to 10 o'clock. During morning meeting, we normally ask a question just to get the kids warmed up for the day. We go over the daily schedule. Then right from there, the remote students stay logged on. And from 9 to 9:40, we do math. This is whole group math. Then from there, from 9:45 to 10:25, is iReady in the classroom with some students, and then iReady for the students at home. They should be doing about 20-ish minutes to 30 minutes a day of iReady math. during this block. Then after that, there's also time for independent work till like 10:40. So from pretty much 9 to 10:40 is all math. That might be doing work in their independent work from Google Classroom or in their workbooks. At 10:40, we go to recess. And that ends at 11, and we go right back, then we go right to lunch. During this time, for the remote students, they might be eating a snack. They're just pretty much taking a brain break. So lunch ends around 11:30, and then we go right into ELA, whole group. This runs until 12:35. So during this session, of course, the remote students and in-person students are all doing ELA together. And during ELA, we're reading stories, and we'll get into that a little bit more later. After ELA, it's specials. So each grade has their own special, and that's rotating once a month, as you saw. And that will go from 12:35 to 1:15. And remote students also attend this. They just log out of the Google Meet they're in and log in to whatever special they're going to. From there, it's 1:20 to 2:15 is their writing. Once again, the remote students should be logged on for the writing block. And we're all, normally there's like a quick introduction of what we're going to be writing about for that day, or they're continuing on their writing from a previous day, all the way until 2:15. 2:15 is technically the last time the remote students are with us for the day, because then we go to recess in here, and then we have a room sanitation time, where children are wiping things down, cleaning their desks, they might be cleaning the floor. And before we know it, the bell rings, and the end of the day is here.
So, este es el horario de los estudiantes que están remotos y los que están en persona. Tenemos lo que está en negro, es, bueno, ellos, los que están en persona van en todo, para todo, en todo momento. Lo que está en azul es lo que los estudiantes que están remotos, los que están virtual, pasan por ello, ¿no? Tenemos desayuno de 8:15 a 8:45. Comienza el morning meeting, la reunión de la mañana de 8:45 a 9. Se revisa el horario diario. Vamos a lo que es matemática en grupo completo de 9 a 9:40. Y eso continúa de 9:40 a 10 y 25 en trabajo independiente, donde el estudiante que está remoto debe de estar conectado con nosotros. De 10 y 25 a 10 y 40 son los centros de matemática, que entonces serían, es trabajo independiente en casa, y así que no tienen que estar conectados con nosotros. Recreo es de 10 y 40 a 11 de la mañana, y de 11 a 11 y media es almuerzo, así que los estudiantes que están en casa deben de tener su almuerzo o su merienda. Y de esa misma manera, ¿verdad?, tener un brain break, un espacio para descanso. Después de eso, continuamos con lo que es inglés, lo que conocemos como ELA, que es la clase de inglés. Estamos desde las 11:35, todo hasta las 12:35 en grupo completo. De 2:35 a 1:15 tenemos lo que son nuestras clases de área especial, y eso varía dependiendo al salón en el que su estudiante esté. Después de 1:20 a 2:15 tenemos escritura, y en el área de escritura nosotros lo que estamos haciendo es que o comenzamos, ellos deben de estar conectados, y o comenzamos a escribir algo nuevo, se le dan las instrucciones, o continuamos con lo que ya había comenzado el día anterior. A esa hora, a las 2:15, cuando se acaba la escritura, el día para los remotos ahí termina, porque entonces para nosotros tenemos recreo, y después ellos vienen del recreo, limpian el salón, acomodan todo, desinfectan absolutamente todo, y ya cuando nos damos cuenta son las 3 de la tarde y tenemos que ir a casa.
Okay, next thing is attendance. Attendance is everything for remote and in person. You should be here almost every day. For the remote students, we do use the attendance so that we can keep track of who's here and who's not. And that's being marked down for every subject area. So for math in the morning or morning meeting and then ELA in the afternoon and then writing. You should be attending every one of those classes. That's super, super important. Also for attendance, if students' cameras are not on or they're doing a task that is unexpected, like watching TV or having side conversations, their attendance might be marked because of that, because they should be attending for that in-person learning, because they're part of this classroom still. And then once again, just in case you didn't get it last time, the blue spots on the schedule are when kids should be logging in. Those are the main times. And of course, we are offering times where they can stay on longer if they please, but it's really just those blue times are the main times to come in.
So, en la asistencia a los estudiantes, se espera que ellos atiendan a las clases. A menos que no sea una emergencia, si tienes alguna emergencia, obviamente, ¿verdad? Pues por favor, vamos a atenderla. Pero si no es una emergencia, por favor, esperamos que nuestros estudiantes atiendan a las clases, todos los estudiantes. La asistencia de los estudiantes está siendo, ¿verdad? Tomada, estamos tomando asistencia, igual que como si estuvieran aquí todos los días. Los que están en persona y los que están virtual. Así es que esto es una de las cosas bien importantes. Otra de las cosas importantes para los estudiantes que están remotos es que su cámara debe de estar prendida todo el tiempo para que puedan ser marcados presentes. Si tu cámara está apagada, lamentablemente, vas a estar ausente ese día. Los estudiantes que están virtual también deben de atender en el área de su horario que está en color azul para poder recibir toda la asistencia del día, porque si no puede ser que si viene en una parte del azul, quizás le damos, ¿verdad?, medio día de asistencia y no el día completo. Así es que tengamos presente eso.
Okay, so we're just gonna go over our online expectations for us. Let's click on this. So these are like the three school rules. We have respectful, responsible, and safe. For being respectful, the eye should be on the speaker. That's like the whole thing with the camera. And then one person speaking at a time. So if everyone's unmuted and then kids in here are also talking, it's just hard to hear. Raise your hands if you have to speak, or you can always use the comment box. Use kind words and language in the chat box. And in here, we are trying to make sure that we are staying on topic. Greet everyone with a quiet wave, and then be respectful of the time we have. We all must take turns. That one's pretty big. Make sure that if you're logging into the computer that you're logging in on time. For being responsible, keep your microphone off until you're told to turn it on. Once again, stay on topic, keep on task. Also, sit in a quiet place so you aren't going to have a lot of distractions around. Be in school appropriate clothing. So maybe not your pajamas every day. And then camera is turned on so we can see you. Sometimes the camera is either facing the roof or facing the wall, but we'd like to see you. And then safe would be only log into Hangouts when it's your assigned time and a teacher is there. Also, make sure you have closed the screen at the end of your meeting. So pretty much when the meeting's over, just exit out and then make sure you're careful with the Chromebook. And then teacher must host all meetings and is the last one to leave. The teacher will always be the last one to leave when you're in the meeting, and that's just for your own safety. Where is this again? Here
that. All right, so las expectativas del salón virtual, si estás ¿verdad? Virtual, pues tenemos unas expectativas para ser responsable. Ojos en la persona que está hablando. Una sola persona habla al momento. Se levanta la mano si tienes que hablar. Dices permiso y todos esos valores que enseñamos en casa. Usa palabras que sean de valor, ¿no? Que sean cuidadosas cuando hablemos y tenemos que cuidar nuestro lenguaje de la manera en que nosotros hablamos y cómo podemos expresarnos. Saluda a todo el mundo, ¿verdad? Calladamente, con un hola, quizás diciéndole hola con tus manos. Sé respetuoso todo el tiempo. Y tenemos que tomar turnos. Siendo responsables, para ser responsables, pedimos que tengan su micrófono apagados hasta que sea tu turno de hablar. Mantenerte en el tópico en el que estamos hablando. Estar todo el tiempo, ¿verdad?, haciendo tu trabajo como debes de estar haciéndolo. Sentarte callado en tu sitio, con sus cuerpos calmados, no así o así. sin ninguna distracción cerca de nosotros. Estar en la escuela con la ropa apropiada, no todo el tiempo en pijamas. La cámara debe estar todo el tiempo mirándote a ti, no al techo o al piso o al lado. Para mantenernos seguros, tenemos que solamente entrar al link cuando estamos, ¿verdad? Cuando están asignados, en el tiempo que está asignado, asegurarte de que cierres tu pantalla cuando termina el meeting. Y la última persona que debe de salir del meeting es el maestro. ¿Ok? Así que...
So we're going to watch a quick video of synchronous learning. This is actually from Mrs. Payne's class. So if you don't know what synchronous learning is, this is just teaching a whole group for in-person and remote at the exact same time. Once again, here's a little demonstration of what that might look like.
I'm Wildcat Families. My name is and I have the pleasure of being the principal of Westview School. Thank you all for joining us on our virtual open house. We're going to take care of some things that you really need to know about, and we look forward to hearing back from you. Hi, everybody. I'm Caitlin Jacobs. I'm the proud assistant principal here at West Street School. Mrs. Wilson and I are now going to take you on a tour of our synchronous learning here at West Street. At West Street, all classrooms are engaging in synchronous learning, so you will get a peek into what that looks like.
Between the dots in your anthology, it can be found on page 48 through 51. Those of you using the reading companion, it is on page 50 and 51. Thumbs up when you're ready. Thank you, Victoria. How do I know that Victoria is ready? Green card. Thank you, guys. Okay. First of all, Real, Annie. So that sometimes we are voices. Okay, so Addie is saying that Braille is made for blind. Does anyone want to add to that? Anyone at home want to add what you think Braille is? You may put it in the chat. You may use your dry erase board. What is Braille? So one of our jobs today is using our prior knowledge to make connections to our story.
That was just a short mini clip. So as you saw, Mrs. Payne was in front of the room teaching the kids in person, and then she also had the camera on her around that front desk where they were using the chat or maybe raising their hand and answering out loud. All right, Ms. McGann's actually gonna take over from here. Thank you, everyone.
Hi, friends at home. My name is Miss McGann. I'm another one of our fifth grade teachers. So these are some of the different platforms that we are going to be using when we are working online. Starting hopefully next week, if not the week after that, everybody's going to have access to this every day because we will have computers for everybody in the classroom as well. So our biggest one, we have our Google Classroom. On Google Classroom, you're going to find all of our assignments that we need. We're going to post any announcements there as well as ClassDojo. You're going to have all of our content areas, so everything that we're doing in reading and in math, and then science and social studies is kind of embedded in that as well. Our assignments are there, the tests are there, and parents also have access to this, so the kids can do their work in there, and the parents can see everything we're posting as well as the kids' work too. ClassDojo, we all use ClassDojo. This is our main method for contact. So you can message us in here. It's awesome if you need to translate to another language because you can click a button and it'll translate it for you. And it includes all of our points throughout the day that kids earn for following those three school rules, being respectful, responsible, and safe. And anytime we have an announcement when there's gonna be a holiday or something coming up in school, it's gonna be posted in there as well. Clever is our main platform for our curriculum. So you will have the iReady is included in there. All of our Wonders reading and writing is in there. Our brand new awesome math program is in there as well. And all of the games that you could use to learn what we're working on in class, you can find in there also.
Okay, estas son las plataformas que están virtuales, que las que nosotros utilizamos. Comenzando la semana que viene, son nuestras expectativas de que todos los estudiantes tengan una computadora en el salón, así es que todos nosotros tendríamos la oportunidad de tener acceso a todas estas plataformas. Una de las mayores que usamos es Google Classroom, y esa es la plataforma más usada para nosotros poder enseñar en todas las áreas. Las asignaciones y los exámenes están ahí puestos, ¿no? Como están posteados, como decimos nosotros en Spanglish. Permite a los padres a que vean las expectativas para los estudiantes. También tenemos ClassDojo, que es la manera más fácil y más fácil para nosotros poder comunicarnos, es la más rápida también, ya que estamos dentro del salón y tenemos acceso a nuestra computadora todo el tiempo. Y es súper efectivo porque puede traducirte el mensaje en cualquier lenguaje si se te hace difícil el inglés. También puedes ver como padre los puntos positivos esas cositas positivas que se le dan en el salón. Puedes ver cómo están en su comportamiento a través de esta aplicación también. Y también están los anuncios semanales. También tenemos Clever, que entonces la plataforma que tiene el distrito es una plataforma de enseñanza virtual. Tenemos lo que es iReady. Wonders, que es nuestro programa de lectura y escritura. Tenemos nuestro programa de matemáticas y también tenemos juegos educativos que pueden ayudarles a aprender jugando.
Okay, so when you are getting into Google Classroom, most of you, probably maybe all of you, recognize the waffle. So when you get into your Google account, there will be the waffle that's the nine dots in the top right. You can click on that and Google Classroom will be one of your options. Or you can log right into Clever and Google Classroom is in there as well. You can find your specific teacher's class. So you are going to be in Mr. Maturi's class, Ms. Payne's class, or my class, depending on who your teacher is. That's what's going to pop up when you click on Google Classroom. You can click on the stream, which is just going to be everything listed from the most recent down to older assignments. Or you also can click on the classwork tab, which will have everything organized by week. So we will create a new topic every Monday, and as we post assignments, it's going to pop up in that week. So right now we're in week 10-19 to 10-23, and everything we've been working on in this week is included in that folder. So, oh, that's what I said right there. Perfect. I was just going off the top of my head, but I said it, so.
Okay. En Google Classroom vas a encontrar, para encontrar las asignaciones, ¿no? O las tareas que tienen ese día, el estudiante va a entrar a través de Clever o de su o del email Waffle, que es lo que es el waffle en español, que está en la parte de arriba, de la parte izquierda arriba de su email. Va a encontrar 9 puntitos y ahí es como un cuadrito, 9 puntitos, y él va a darle, el estudiante solamente le hace un clic ahí, va a encontrar que va a poder encontrar a Clever. Los estudiantes buscan la clase específica del maestro, por ejemplo, Mr. Maturi's Masterminds, o Payne's Patient Fifth Graders, o Miss Megan's Marvelous Fifth Graders. Buscas tu clase, entras ahí y ya puedes entonces tener acceso. Ellos tienen, ellos entran a lo que es la página, o a la parte de arriba dice trabajo, classwork, y ellos le van a dar ahí y ellos van a poder localizar sus tareas diarias por semanas. Por ejemplo, esta semana es, what is this week? 10-19 al 10-23. So, tenemos todas las semanas van a estar con sus números, con sus números. Así es que si estamos, asegúrate de estar en la semana correcta, y si tienes trabajos atrasados, ir a la semana anterior.
Okay. So, every time you get into one of our meetings, you're going to log into Clever or the email to get to the Google Classroom. You're going to find your teacher's class. All of you guys are masters at this point, because we do it every day. You're going to click on our link, and then you will be logged in. You won't be able to get into the meeting unless your teacher is already there. So if you're a little bit early, just be patient, because it won't let you in until one of us fifth grade teachers is already in there.
So para entrar al link de la reunión virtual, tienes que otra vez entrar por Clever o entras por tu email. Como te habíamos comentado, buscas lo que es Google Meet, perdóname. Es una camarita y ahí te va a aparecer. Entras a Google Classroom, buscas el nombre específico de tu maestro, entras ahí, le vas a dar clic a un link que aparece en la parte de arriba y no te va a dejar conectarte hasta que el maestro no esté presente. Así es que si en algún momento dado estás tratando de entrar y ves que no te deja, no te desesperes, simple y sencillamente espera, porque a lo más seguro el maestro está atendiendo algo aquí y no ha podido entrar a la reunión.
Okay, so our program for both reading and writing is the Wonders program. We use the Clever portion of Wonders for all of our reading. So all of the stories that we're working on together, the reading writing companion is in there. Sometimes we'll assign our spelling or class assignments into the Clever website. All of us are using Google Docs for the writing, because we can go right into that document and write suggestions and comments for you that you can go back in and change and fix. We worked on a personal narrative in September. We did realistic fiction that we just wrapped up this month, and we are getting into our opinion and argumentative writing that we just started. In December, we're going to be doing informational, and poetry is going to be in January. This is a link, right? I can click on it. Okay. All right, so I'll just show you a little bit what it looks like. So when you log in, this is what your page is going to look like. Whenever we are doing reading in class, you are going to click on McGraw-Hill, and that will bring you right into that day's reading. You can access all of the texts in here. We'll pull up the student one just so you can see what it looks like online. So when you log into Clever, you're going to go into McGraw-Hill. You'll click on your text, and you will have all of your options right in front of you. So the green circle is your to-do section. That's anytime we assign stuff for you, it'll be listed right there. Any tests that we give you, any practices. There are games for you. We can look up words to know. This is going to be anything we're focused on for that week is going to be in here. Our vocabulary words, it'll have the meaning. It'll show you a picture and it'll use the word for you. The writer's notebook we really aren't using because those docs are a lot easier to give you advice. And then the text is there as well. So do you want this or the slide?
Stop there and then I can go back to the slide. Perfect. Les voy a explicar un poco primero esto para entonces ir al slide, al anterior. Pero esto es lo que es... La parte de escritura y de lectura, este es el, vas a ir a McGraw-Hill en este link. Entonces vas a entrar aquí en esta área de aquí, es donde es la lista de las cosas, de las cosas que tienes que hacer ese día o si tienes algo atrasado, está en el área verde. Esta, donde dice words to know, son prácticamente palabras de dictado, de deletreo, vocabulario, etcétera, etcétera. Juegos y pues el libro y la libreta, la escritura. You guys are not using this, is what you're saying?
The notebook we haven't been, because we put it in documents, because we can write to them.
So, lo de la libretita para la escritura no se ha estado usando porque preferimos usar documentos, ya que, ¿verdad? Nosotros podemos escribir y editar cualquier cosa que necesitemos editar. Esto no nos lo permite. Can you go back?
Yep. It's the yellow one right here. This one.
Yeah. Okay. So, explicándole esta parte, el programa de escritura y de lectura se llama Wonders, que era donde nosotros estábamos casi ahora. Y en septiembre usamos lo que era una narrativa personal. En octubre realizamos lo que era una ficción realista. En noviembre vamos a trabajar con lo que es una opinión argumentativa. En diciembre vamos a trabajar con documentos que son informacionales. Y en enero vamos a trabajar con poesía.
Slow down. Hi guys, most of you know me. I'm Mrs. Payne. I'm another fifth grade teacher, and I'm going to show you just bits and pieces of our new math program called Ready Math. So these are the units, unit 1 through 5, multiplying, division. We've already done area, volume. Unit 2 is decimals, fractions, place value, adding and subtracting with fractions. Unit 3 is decimal and fractions, place value, multiplying and dividing. And I'm sure kids can't wait to do that. Unit 4 is measurement, data, and geometry. This may be a little slower for us because in fifth grade, that is an area in math that they did miss. So we're going to give this with a little bit of tender, loving care for fourth grade, moving it into fifth. And unit 5 is algebra, coordinated planes. So let's take a quick peek on...
Okay. Sorry. Okay. Voy a traducir esto rapidito para que así podamos ir juntos. Este es nuestro programa de matemática que se llama Ready Math. Y está dividido en 5 unidades. Tenemos desde la unidad 1 hasta la unidad 5, la primera unidad siendo multiplicación y división, La segunda unidad siendo decimales y fracciones. Y también tenemos lo que es valor posicional, suma y resta. Tenemos en la unidad 3 lo que son los decimales y fracciones otra vez. Valor posicional, multiplicando y dividiendo. La unidad 4, todo lo que son medidas, data y geometría. Y en esa parte vamos a tener un poquito de más cuidado por el hecho de que lamentablemente perdieron por esta transición de la pandemia, perdieron un poquito de esa área, pero vamos a llevarlo donde tenemos que llevarnos. Y la unidad 5 vamos a tener álgebra planes coordinados y puntos gráficos.
Okay, so let's take a quick little peek into the math program. A lot of wonderful things in here. I'm not going to go through everything because there is so much. So again, when students log on, they're going to go to their Clever site, go to the iReady. Oops, let's click it over. And fifth grade. So these are the units that we have covered already. And if you notice, we have lots of tools and different platforms in the math that we can cover. Our instruction is in here. We have both student and teacher. We have interactive tutorials, which kids love to watch. It just breaks it down for them a little bit better and in a fun way. Quizzes, lessons, so how are we assessing students, prerequisite lessons, tools for instruction. It comes with math center activities that kids can click into and enrichment activities. Also comes in Spanish, which is nice. Our newsletters come in English and Spanish, which are being sent home to parents. I put mine in Class Dojo as well. I find that parents access Class Dojo much easier.
So, esta es nuestra plataforma, es nuestra plataforma de matemáticas, y ellos entrarían de la misma manera. Entran a su Clever, y en Clever va a encontrar VeriMath. Entonces, aquí están todas las unidades. Si se dan cuenta, tenemos muchas herramientas para usar con ellos. Y tenemos las noticias están en español y en inglés y se están también tratando de enviar por ClassDojo.
Okay, so let me just show you one page. This is what we see when we log into it. And if you notice, here's the teacher page. That pulls up and this is the letter in English and Spanish, but it shows parents what students will be looking at. We can also pull this up on our projector and model it with students. They also come up to the board and show their thinking with it.
So esta es una de las, put it down so I can. So esto es una de las noticias que de las que le estamos hablando. So, es una carta prácticamente a los papás para explicarles y decirles cómo es que su hijo va a estar trabajando en ciertas cosas, ¿no? Por ejemplo, cómo hacer, qué hacer, con ejemplos, etcétera. Así que si le toca, ¿verdad?, ayudarlo por X o Y razón en casa, pues tiene el cómo hacerlo. Esto también se usa, son herramientas que se usan en la escuela, ¿verdad? Y entonces así ellos nos pueden enseñar su forma de pensar en cómo resolver problemas matemáticos.
Okay, and the last is the ESOL for English language speakers and other languages. Our new ESOL teacher is Mr. Hogan, who is, I believe, in another class, but he is providing support services to our students that do speak another language. We're very fortunate to have him. They practice and review what students need the help with the most, and they also try to align their lessons and their instructions to what the classroom teacher is doing. Yeah.
So, este es lo que se le conoce como ESL, por, ¿verdad? Por su traducción en las siglas en inglés, que son English for Speakers of Other Languages. And so, ellos prácticamente son estudiantes que no hablan muy bien inglés y entonces toman esta clase de soporte. Esta clase es para brindar apoyo adicional a los estudiantes que no hablan inglés como primer idioma en esta clase. Nosotros practicamos y revisamos aquellos con lo que los estudiantes necesitan más ayuda, ya sea fluidez en la lectura, vocabulario u ortografía. Trabajamos en asignaciones, tareas, actividades del bloque ELA, artes del lenguaje de inglés. Practicamos hablar inglés con amistades, con nuestros compañeros, y practicamos la escritura.
Okay, so that's the end of our presentation. We thank you so much for joining us this evening on our virtual open house, our first one. If you have any questions, please reach out to fifth grade teachers, anyone at the office. We'd love to hear from you. Have a good night.
Bye, guys. Have a good night.
If you have questions.
Si tienen alguna pregunta, pueden, ¿verdad?, escribirla. Muchas gracias por acompañarnos en esta nuestra primera casa abierta virtual. Ha sido un placer estar con ustedes.
Is there any questions?
¿Alguna pregunta?
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Thank you.
Gracias. See you tomorrow, Isabella.
whose mom is that?
Gracias, Elise.
Oh, okay.
Thank you again.
Gracias.
So impressive. Oh my goodness.
Remember from the presentation. Cool.